the same exact spot, and then you'll fight a shaman. The shaman is the one who draws a butt slam. He'll rise up in the air and slam down on the ground. What you want to do in this phase is you want to back up, wait for him to smash down, and then grappling hook to him. If you try to heal up in this phase really close, he's going to knock you back, and he'll stun you out of your healing animation. So definitely don't heal during that part. Now, he has one other distinct move that was getting me for the longest amount of time. He'll do the Perilous symbol, and he'll charge at you. It's a one-hit kill, almost. And this, whenever he does that, whenever you see that symbol, instantly push the jump button. You avoid it every single time. Now, this took me so long to get. But this will avoid you, like, it's right here, but it will stop you from getting killed all the time. Now, that was the deciding factor in order for me to actually get him through his first two phases. Once he enters into his second phase, now this is when it changes. Once he gets into his second phase, you want to back away from him, and then he'll do it in the burst. During this time, heal as much as you can. And then once he gets done doing his burst, run up to him, attack him as many times as you can. He's probably going to do the Perilous Charge, so get ready to jump over him. Only this time, when he does the charge, he's going to wrap back around him, he's going to toss a flame. When he tosses his flame, runs his arm, just dodge to the side, and then jump. It's another jump animation to actually miss that Perilous attack on him. And then this, he's going for a few steps, should be able to get to his final form. In his final form, this is where he's gonna do like a circular flame motion. He's gonna start off right away, so there's no little like stun animation that he's gonna get into. He's gonna do like a Perilous Flame animation. You need to jump I believe it's two times more right next to it.